It is exactly 1 week since we received the fantabulous news that a Ugandan had been nominated for the prestigious Nobel Peace Prize. And tonight on Hashtag, we are privileged to host Victor Ochieng himself. He's 33, he's Africa's youngest person to be nominated for this Peace Prize, and he will be with us on the show sharing his experience, his story, and his expectations. The hashtag we're using tonight is Victor Ochieng. That is hashtag Victor Ochieng. But first, let's welcome our new partners on the show, Vodafone Uganda. This is the stress-free, happy telecom network that you've been waiting for. It is the messiah that will save you from all those stresses you have with all those other telcos. So tonight on the show, you should be switching to 0723, and I'll be telling you details about Vodafone later on the show. But first, let's take a look at those conversations that you had on social media today, and I'm sure most of them were powered by Vodafone Uganda. Now, the top conversation on Twitter today was hashtag TCAMP, which was a Twitter by the Tobacco Control. And here, social media people were trying to understand the cost, the consequences, and of course, the rights of smokers and non-smokers. This is a conversation that you should be very interested in. It is still going on, and you can tell us what you think about smoking in Uganda and tobacco control, because this is one that will definitely affect you. But the other conversation that was huge on social media today was one that was between Simon Kaheru and Mwine Edgar. This has been going on for a week, and tonight they finally actually met together, and this was on our morning show Urban Today, and they still discussed youth unemployment. I'm not sure they came up with so many practical solutions, but one of them that I actually noticed was that they said they're going to have a home online for all these conversations about young people, attitudes, and unemployment. And I'm looking forward to having those conversations there. And that was Viral Load for you tonight. Remember that conversations on social media are powered by Vodafone Uganda. It is now time for us to meet our hero of the night, Mr. Victor Ochieng himself. So come with me. And we say, what's up? How are you?
I'm very well. I'm good to see you.
Very good to see you. We're very excited to have you on Urban TV.
I'm looking forward to telling my stories.
Okay, now how you can get in touch with us is use that hashtag Victor Ochieng on Twitter, and also on our Facebook page, you have that question for you. Send in all those questions, and you will be able to hear from the man himself after this show. I told you I have good news for you from Vodafone. Now, remember that with Vodafone, you do not have to actually lose your data at the end of the month because of an unused data bundle. If you have an unused data bundle at the end of the month, you can actually carry it forward with Vodafone Uganda. There will be more good news coming out of Vodafone, and I'll be letting you know about it. But the first thing you need to do is switch to 0723, and that's the number for Vodafone. But for now, let's get back to the conversation today. I have Victor with me. Congratulations, first of all.
I'm happy. My pleasure. Thanks a lot.
How are you?
I am very well. I'm happy. I'm humbled. I'm excited to be meeting you and the rest of the audience.
Oh, really? Are you still the same? How does it feel to be a Nobel Peace Prize nominee?
It's humbling. I feel so humbled, but also at the same time, a lot of responsibilities ahead.
Okay.
It has come quite early, so we need to work towards. There's so much responsibility attached to. And I'm also excited about, you know, we're doing our humble work at the local community level. Little did we know that it was going to take us to this international platform,
okay,
which is quite exciting. And yes, I'm happy. I'm very happy. I'm so excited about the nomination. My team were dancing. My father was asking, what is it?
Uh-huh. I know so many people are asking about the Nobel Peace Prize, yeah. But it's, I'm glad you've talked about your father. We'll be talking about your family and who you are. But very fast, where have you been?
I have been to Lira. Uh-huh. Sometimes I'll go to Alep Tong. I'm originally from Alep Tong. Okay. Abia is my home where I was born. And I studied in Lira. I lived in Lira. I came to Kampala. My first time to Kampala was in 2002.
Okay.
And since then, I've been commuting between Kampala, Lira, and also my work has been taking me a lot out of the country. A lot of people think I'm a lawyer. I'm not a lawyer.
Oh!
I am not a lawyer, but I do a lot of advocacy for the rights and justice, or you know, for the human rights of the victims. And I do a lot. I'm such an advocate for the victims' rights and justice.
I feel like this show is going to be putting the facts straight, because there's so many things that we have on social media or as the media that are not right. Why do people think you're a lawyer? Are you studying law?
No, I've never studied law, but I do work a lot with the lawyers. A lot of people, also too many victims in the communities, they think I'm a doctor because I do a lot of medical rehabilitation program for the victims,
yes,
of human rights violation, victims of war. So most of them calls me doctor in the community. But also when I come to the platform like Kampala or international level, I am advocating for the rights of the victims. I represent victims at different levels, at the national, internationally. Lastly, not so long ago, I was speaking at the ICC advocating for the rights of the victims. So I identify myself so much with the victims. And that's why people think I'm a lawyer.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, he's here himself.
I know. Lawyer to advocate for rights, right?
I know everybody believes you're a lawyer, so I might actually also add and say.
Maybe I should go to study law now.
You should actually study law, maybe, because you're already doing practicing law, which is fighting for justice. But we have Victor Ochieng himself. He's in the house. He is a Nobel Peace Prize nominee for the year 2015. He is a doctor, he is a lawyer, and he's so many things. And tonight he is our guest, so you can send in your questions. If you want to hear his story, you're actually here. Hearing it from the horse's mouth himself. So very quickly, I have a few minutes before we take a break, but just introduce us to your bio because we're still getting to know you. Grassroots activist, human rights advocate, and a peace builder, and you have the African Youth Initiative. Just introduce us to that. You know that you're jointly nominated with it. Huh?
Mm-hmm. Well, like I said, my name is Victor Ochieng. I'm a Ugandan. I'm 33 years right now. I was born on the 16th of September, 1981.
Okay.
In my little unknown village called Abia in Aleptong.
Ah.
Which is far away.
I've been to Aleptong.
Oh, welcome home again, so no problem. So, yes, I studied in Lira. I grew up in the IDP camp. You know, I'm one of the graduates from the IDP camp, living up there in terms of the war that happened in the north. I never ran out of the region. I stayed there. The farthest you could run was from Aleptong to Lira district, to Lira town. But all along, Abia became one of the biggest IDP camp. I grew up there.
Okay.
So in the context of struggle and studies like that, I went to my primary school in Abia P7 school, which I studied P1 and P2. P2 I studied only one term. And then after that, the insecurity from cattle rustling intensified. Alice Lakwena was also around. We were displaced for about 4 more years without going to school. Generally, not to tell the Minister of Education, I skipped P3, P4, and I went all the way to P5.
Oh dear.
Yes, because for those years I was afraid that if I go back to start studying P2 again, my colleagues, my age mates were going to be my teachers.
Oh yes.
And I wasn't so happy for that. And I told my mom, said, I have to go and study P6. And then they said, no, you can't. You have to go to at least P3. And I told her, I said, if I have to move forward, I cannot study backward. I have to go on.
Okay.
And then I went to P5. Second term. And then that was in a weird primary school in Apache. And when I was studying there, I remember the first month when I got to school, I never saw a tick good in my book. I didn't know anything, but I had the desire that I told my mom that if the exam is to be brought from whatever is taught now, I'll pass. And I remember when I was at home, we had no single textbook. The only textbook we had was a torn apart Holy Bible. It's a quarter of it was left at home.
Oh dear.
So over the years, I kept on reading that. I knew how to speak a bit of English.
Uh-huh.
That's why my English is not very nice, because I missed the, you know.
It's good enough to make you a lawyer and a medical doctor and a Nobel Peace Prize and a nominee. I think that's good enough, but your story still gets more interesting.
Yeah.
And we're going to take a very short break right now. But for you who is watching at home, after the break, we're now going to be focusing on the fact that he has been nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize. What is the Nobel Peace Prize? What does African Youth Initiative actually do? And then we'll also be finding out whether you can actually do anything about making sure that he actually becomes a Nobel Peace Prize laureate.